नमस्कार आदाब एंड वेलकम टू ऑल माय डियर फ्रेंड्स एंड एस्पिरेंट्स. फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल कंग्रेचुलेशंस टू वन एंड ऑल बिकॉज यू आर वाचिंग दिस पर्टिकुलर लेसन सो एज टू गेन सम मोर नॉलेज एंड सक्सीड इन योर लाइफ एंड मेक योर ड्रीम कम ट्रू. सो कंग्रेचुलेशंस फॉर दैट स्पिरिट टू लर्न मोर मोर एंड मोर सो एज टू मेक योर ड्रीम कम ट्रू. एंड आई एम वेरी हैप्पी दैट आई एम अ पार्ट of your preparation because I'm helping you with all the knowledge I'm having. I'm just sharing my knowledge and you people are encouraging me to do some more videos and teach so many new things to you. I'm very happy about that. So now I would not be wasting much of your valuable time as you people are working very hard and investing your hard and valuable time so as to gain the success. So first of all, congratulations as you are on your path to your success and you're working very hard. Keep working hard. Definitely that will fetch you the success which you are thinking. So now today in this particular lesson as a part of Indian polity, now I'm going to discuss about the Election Commission of India. Election Commission of India is a constitutional body as provided in our Constitution of India. And you all know what are constitutional bodies. And in this particular lesson, Election Commission of India, I'll be explaining you the body of Election Commission and how many members are there, what are the service conditions, what are the functions performed by the Election Commission, and what is the significance of Election Commission of India. I hope you all people are responsible citizens because before becoming a responsible civil servant in the government of India, you should be a responsible citizen. So I request all of you to participate in the elections whenever the elections are conducted because your vote will reflect the public opinion and definitely will play a crucial role in selecting a perfect legislator who can make laws for the welfare of your own people. Okay, so in this particular lesson, first let us start with the basic things of Election Commission of India. Article 324 in our Constitution says that so as to conduct free and fair elections, an independent Election Commission has been provided. Okay, so what is the purpose of Election Commission? The main purpose of Election Commission of India is to conduct free and fair elections in our country so that the legislators who are recommended by the people, those people can only come into the parliament and be a part of law making. Is it clear? So in Election Commission of India, there will be a total of 3 members, and out of those 3 members, one will be Chief Election Commissioner, and he will be assisted by 2 different Election Commissioners. Is it clear? So remember, there will be 3 members. One is the Chief Election Commissioner and he will be assisted by 2 other Election Commissioners. Is it clear? And here, how to remember this article, that Article 324 is all about the Election Commission of India. See, let us say 3 is your lucky number. Now minus 1 from 3, that is 2, and plus 1, 3, plus 3, that is 4. So 324, in this way you can remember this article and you can use your own techniques to remember this particular article. Now let's move on to the next important thing. The members of Election Commission are basically appointed by the President of India. Okay. And the Election Commissioner of India is always appointed by the President of India for a fixed term. Okay, for a fixed term. And what is that particular term? The term is 6 years. Okay, so the term or tenure of Election Commissioner is 6 years, or the age of 65 years, whichever is earlier. That means basically the term of office of the Election Commission is 6 years. Okay, how much? 6 years. Basically the tenure of an Election Commissioner is 6 years, but that particular person is having the age of 63. That means he can work 2 more years, because 65 years is the maximum age for a Election Commissioner to work. Okay, that means basically an election commissioner will be holding the office for 6 years. But before the completion of 6 years, if he or she is attaining the age of 65 years, then the term of office will end there itself. That is it clear? That means the term of office is 6 years, or otherwise 65 years of age, whichever is earlier. Is it clear? Okay. Now, what are the condition and what are conditions of service? What are the tenure, or what is the tenure of office, and all these things are determined by an act of parliament, and that particular act is the Chief Election Commissioner and Other Election Commissioners Conditions of Service Act 1991. Is it clear? So which act is determining the condition of services and tenure of office of Chief Election Commissioner? The act is the Chief Election Commissioner and Other Election Commissioners Conditions of Service Act 1991. Is it clear? Okay. Now, this particular act is determining the conditions and service of the election commissioners and Chief Election Commissioner. That is okay, but according to this particular law, what is the salary of Chief Election Commissioner? Simple, it is equal to the salary of that of a judge of Supreme Court. That means whatever the salary a judge of Supreme Court is getting, the same salary will be paid to the Chief Election Commissioner and the Election Commissioner. Now, don't ask me what is the salary of Chief Election Commissioner, because it is not necessary, my dear friends. Let's move on to the next important thing. Now, the Chief Election Commissioner and the other election commissioners will be having all the important after retirement benefits, like the pension and other retirement benefits will be applicable to him, and those retirement benefits and pension will be equivalent to that those particular benefits which are provided to the judge of a Supreme Court. Is it clear? Now the most important thing is that the Election Commission will carry on its business in an unanimously transacted manner. That means whatever the activities are done by the Election Commission, no other body can interfere in the activities of Election Commission. Is it clear? That means Election Commission has been given enough independence so as to carry on its own business of conducting free and fair elections in our country. For that purpose, so much of independence is given to Election Commission, and for that purpose it has been given the right to transact all its business unanimously. Is it clear? And if the Election Commission thinks that they need assistance, they can take the help of the Home Ministry so as to provide security for the conduct of Election Commission, and so many other departments can also help the Election Commission in conducting the elections. Is it clear? Okay. Now, how the decisions are made by the Election Commission regarding the elections? As I have said that there are three members in Election Commissioner. So out of these three members, the decision of the majority will prevail. That means out of these three, if any two people, that means it can be either Election Commissioner and it can be the CEC, that means the Chief Election Commissioner, whoever it may be, whatever the decision is being taken by them will be taken as majority. That means, let us say they want to take a particular decision regarding something, but Election Commissioner is saying something, the other Election Commissioner is saying something, and the Chief Election Commissioner is saying something. In that particular situation, when there is difference of opinion, then the majority decision will be taken. That means if both the Election Commissioners are having the same opinion, unlike that of the Chief Election Commissioner, then the decision of Election Commissioner will be taken into account, and the action will be taken as per that particular decision. Okay, then let's move on to the next important thing. Now, what are the duties of the Election Commissioners? Basically, the duty of election commissioners or the election commission is to supervise the elections of the president, the election of the vice president, the election of the members of Lok Sabha, members of Rajya Sabha, and even the election of members of legislative assemblies in different states, and even if possible in union territories also. So regarding the election of all these particular people, the Election Commission of India will take all necessary measures. So the entire burden and responsibility of conducting the elections of the president, vice president, members of Lok Sabha and Rajya Sabha, and members of legislative assemblies of different state will be on the shoulders of Election Commission. Is it clear? Then what are the other duties performed by the Election Commission? The other duties are such that the reservation of seats in Lok Sabha and Lok Sabha and the state legislatures will be decided by the Delimitation Commission, which is being supervised by the Election Commission itself. And the qualification of member of parliament and the qualification of members of legislative assemblies will also be evaluated by the Election Commission, that whether the person who want to contest in the election, he is possessing all the qualifications as mentioned in the constitution or not. It will be checked by the Election Commission itself. And even the determination of population for the purpose of election is also determined by, it is also done by the Election Commission only. The electoral rolls are also prepared by the Election Commission regarding the all the elections that are taking place in our country. And the recognition of political parties and allotment of symbols is the other duty taken up by the Election Commission. And there was a question in 2017 prelims, civil services prelims examination, that what are the duties of the Election Commission, and some statements were given. And out of that statement, one statement was that the allotment of symbols and the disputes regarding the symbols of political parties are resolved by Election Commission. Yes, the Election Commission looks after the disputes regarding the symbols of different political parties. What happened was that in Uttar Pradesh, the CM Akhilesh Yadav and as well as his father, there was a little bit of clash between them, I hope so. Between his father only, I don't really remember, but there was a kind of split in that particular party. So what happened was they wanted the symbol of cycle, because according to them, most of the people of UP recognize that particular party with that particular symbol only. Hence, that symbol was very important for their victory in the election. So both Akhilesh Yadav and his father are fighting for that particular symbol, that symbol should be given to him or them. So that was the dispute. And another dispute was in Tamil Nadu, when after the death of Jayalalitha, what happened is that there was a split in DMK, DMK or AIADMK, I don't really remember, but there was a split in Jayalalitha's party. On one side there was Palaniswamy and on the other side there was Dinakaran. So they were fighting for the symbol of leaf. Okay, so again, regarding that particular dispute also, the Election Commission became the torchbearer in resolving the dispute. And finally, the Election Commission has decided that particular dispute. And even if you people want to contest in the election, you have to file your nomination papers, and those nomination papers will be scrutinized by the Election Commission. And if you have filled anything wrong in that particular nomination paper, and definitely your nomination will be rejected. As a result of that, you cannot contest in the election. So the scrutiny of nomination papers are also undertaken by the Election Commission itself, and whatever the money is spent regarding the election, means election campaigning and advertisements regarding their party, their schemes for the welfare of the people, so as to attract the people, so as to gain the votes, the political parties have the right to advertise, and for that purpose they need so much of money, and so much of political funding is being done by the rich businessmen to the political parties, and so much of money is spent on these elections. So the Election Commission of India always tells that you cannot spend more than this much of money, and how much is spent is to be told to election commission, and each and every party gives the information that how much they have spent regarding their election campaign. And here there is one important thing, that only that particular party wins which spends much more money than the other parties. So it's a great different thing in our Indian elections. So these are the duties conducted by, these are the duties of the Election Commission of India. Now, what are the powers of the Election Commission of India? It superintends and directs and controls all the elections which take place throughout the India, whether it is in the states or whether it is in the union territories. In each and every part of India, in every nook and corner of India, whatever the elections take place, those elections are conducted, superintended, directed and controlled by the Election Commission of India itself. And even whenever there is a dispute regarding any election, then so as to clear those disputes and so as to clear any doubt regarding any election, some tribunals will be appointed by the Election Commission itself. So these were the powers of the Election Commission of India. Now, we are going to discuss about the removal procedure of Chief Election Commissioner. Now, how a Chief Election Commissioner is removed? Okay, so how he is removed? Only by an presidential order, a Chief Election Commissioner will be removed. Is it clear? Okay, and only he can be removed on ground of proved misbehavior. Okay, proved misbehavior or incapacity. Is it clear? He will be removed only on the grounds of proved misbehavior and incapacity. Is it clear? And what is the actual process of his removal? See, basically he is removed in the same manner as a judge of Supreme Court is removed. But what is the process that we have to discuss? What happens is that first, each house separately will pass a particular motion regarding the address of removal of Chief Election Commissioner, and that particular address is supported by each house with a majority of total membership of each house and by a majority of not less than 2/3 of majority of members present and voting. Is it clear? And after that, if both the houses has passed the motion and both the houses has supported the motion by a majority of total membership of each house and by a majority of not less than 2/3 of members present and voting, then the president will pass the presidential order regarding the removal of Chief Election Commissioner. Okay, now, as I have said that there will be two other election commissioners assisting the Chief Election Commissioners. Now, if they do something which comes under the category of proved misbehavior or incapacity, then they also should be removed. And what is the process of their removal? They will be removed in the similar manner, but the matter is that they will be removed and they can be removed only when the Chief Election Commissioner recommends to do so. Okay, the other election commissioners cannot be removed from the office without the recommendation of CEC. That means only if the Chief Election Commissioner recommends that the other two election commissioners should be removed, then they can be removed, otherwise they cannot be removed. Is it clear? So this is all about the Election Commission of India, and I hope you people have understood this particular thing. And I hope I have explained everything very clearly, lucidly, and I hope you people have understood everything, and I wish that you people should work some more harder and reach your goal and make your dreams come true and help so many people in this society and be a responsible citizen. And after learning this lesson, keep all the facts in your brain so that you can score some marks, as well as you will prove that you are a responsible citizen of India, and definitely you will vote in the next general election and show who is the perfect person or the party to rule us. And if you have any doubts, please mention them in the comments. And if you feel that I am doing good, then please hit the like button so that I can get some more energy to make some more lessons and help you people. And if you people think that I have done any mistake or I have not taught in a good manner, then please hit the dislike button. That will tell me that yes, I should improve myself. Thank you very much.